So now that the wallet's been backed up and encrypted, just take a little look around the client software just to know how it all works. So this has a series of tabs up here, and you can see it's got the overview here, and this will give you the balance of the wallet, and the stake is the money that you will make from proof of stake minting, which I will go into some other point. The next tab is the send coins tab. So this is how you will send coins from your wallet to other locations. Now your wallet.dat file contains your private key, but you will also have a public key, which is the address that everybody else will know for where to send peer coins to you. Equally, they will have public addresses and keys that you can send coins to. So what you would do is enter their public address in this section here and then carry out the transaction by putting the amount in and clicking on send. The next tab is the receive coins. This here will show you your public address. So this is the address that you will tell to everybody else if you want peer coins sent to you. This is your address you can get. It's a long key, so you can use this copy to clipboard button. And then obviously whenever you need to paste it somewhere, you can just do it that way. The next one, by the way, sorry, you can also use a QR code as well. Which I don't use, so I don't know much about that, but you can use it for scanning and then getting your public key that way. Transactions, we haven't carried out any transactions, so there's nothing here. But every time you send coins or are receiving coins, they'll show up here. Now, transactions take a little while to go through because they need to be confirmed, and that happens in six stages. So you'll need six different confirmations before you know that the transaction's safely gone through. So you can look at that here. There'll be in this first column here, there'll be a little circle that'll come up when you have a transaction, and it's like it will kind of fill up as the transactions get confirmed. And when six confirmations occur, then you'll have a nice tick saying that the transaction's completed. So that's quite useful tab to use. Address book is if you want to store addresses, public key addresses of other peercoin destinations to send to easily, rather than to have to copy the address from them. And export is to export your settings to wherever you want, really. So there's also a section here for changing your passphrase and some options if you wanted to start on the system startup, that you can tick there, and if you want to minimize the tree, you can tick there. All the other stuff I don't really understand, and all that I don't really okay. Yeah, you can do it in, is it milli peer coins and micro peer coins if you want to show it in smaller denominations. All right, so that's a little quick look around the peer coin software.